when you put a loved one in a nursing home, do you have to surrender all of their land or valuables or anything to the nursing home?
That's a good question, Keisha. And I think that would not just affect you and your information, but other people too. Joel, what's the answer to that?
Keisha, I wish we had more time in this program. It's actually a longer and more complicated answer than I can give in a succinct version, but I'll try to give you the best version that I can. And that is that when the person goes into the nursing home, there's a pretty widespread misconception out there that the nursing homes take things, that they seize things, that they levy things, that they take them away in some fashion, and they don't. Basically, the nursing home is a business no different than any other business, and they expect to be paid for their services. As a result, what that means ultimately is that somebody's got to pay them, and there's usually only three sources from which to do that. One is long-term care insurance, which most people don't have. In which case, that only leaves two sources, and those are that you private pay, you pay out of your own resources, or there is a thing called Medicaid. Distinguished from Medicare, Medicare is when we get to be 65, not that. Medicaid has to do with our assets, and do we have sufficient assets to pay our own way? If we do, then you have to use your own resources. Now, you don't go have to give them your house. You don't have to give them the money in your bank account. What you have to do is sit there and pay the nursing home in Tuscaloosa County, roughly $6,000 a month until those resources are used up. At the end of that, when the resources are used up, you could qualify for Medicaid, and Medicaid will begin paying that part of it to the nursing home directly.
You would have to sell your home to do that. You would qualify for Medicaid without selling your home if your wife's still living there.
Well, and that's the kicker, is if there is a spouse living in the home, then there's an exemption for the house and one vehicle. Okay. If there's no spouse in the home, yes, you do have to sell.